get loose and produce.
What's up, you fucking bitches? So by now, your sound design skills are getting pretty sweet. But if you don't know how to arrange them, your songs may be bound for the demo pile forever. But don't worry, because I got some quick and easy music theory hacks that'll help build a strong foundation for your dance music productions. Let's fucking get into it. Most Western music, and in our case, EDM, is built off one simple concept, the major scale. The major scale has the ability to frame the musical key that our song is in. If we are in the key of E, then we use the notes from the E major scale. The next idea we need to introduce is harmony. Harmony exists whenever more than one note is played at a time. Chords are built using this idea of harmony. And in our case, the most important chord to know is the triad. The triad is achieved when we take the root note, in this case C, skip a note to E, and skip one more note to G. This is the C major triad. I'm gonna go ahead and build triads over every single note of the C major scale. It's gonna sound like this. What we should understand next is a very important concept called scale degrees. Every note of the scale is assigned a number, depending on where it falls in that scale. For example, D in the key of C major is the second note of the scale. 1, 2. Therefore, we call D the second degree of the C major scale. The next important idea is that even in major keys, the scale degrees won't always have major triads. This is what I mean. If we take the first note of C major, we have the C major triad, as we see here. Now, if we were to look at the second scale degree, which is D, 1, 2, we have D minor triad. So, even in the key of C major, the second scale degree is a minor triad. Now, let's examine the triad structure of all seven scale degrees. Luckily for us, this formula will hold no matter what key we are in.
Chord progressions.
A chord progression is simply the scale degrees arranged in a particular order. In EDM, chord progressions are used a lot in more uplifting melodic tracks, such as Mammoth by Dimitri Vegas and Like Mike, or Scared to be Lonely by Martin Garrix. So for example, I found on Google a very popular chord progression that goes 1, 5, 6, 4. The numbers just represent scale degrees of the key. First degree, fifth degree, sixth degree, and fourth degree. Let's start by choosing a random key. Let's say E flat. These are the chords found in the key of E flat. So following the chord progression that we found, we have the first degree, fifth degree, sixth degree, fourth degree. Let's start by arranging the bass line of this chord progression. Now let's build some harmony over top of the bass, using the appropriate triads found from the key. Let's see how it sounds. Once we arrange a basic melody over these chords, we're well on our way in developing basic musical phrasing. If that's not your shit, let's see how these concepts relate to more club or festival type tracks. I want to introduce you to something I call the banger chord degree. The banger chord degree is the third degree of any major scale. So for example, in the key of C, the third degree is the E minor chord. This is the chord that I would recommend building drops over. It has a really nice minor sound, and the next chord is only a semitone away. Can you hear it? Let's start by arranging some simple drums and a bass that stays on E. Cool, let's add some brass for harmonic context. You can clearly hear how using the notes from the third scale degree works extremely well in creating that tense, festival sound. The next concept I want to introduce is the concept of dissonance and consonance. The more dissonant a sound is, the further away from its natural harmony it is. At the same time, a more consonant sound is extremely aligned with the natural harmony. For example, let's play this extremely consonant lead sound over our drop. The fact our lead sound is so consonant, or the fact that the pitch of our lead sound is so steadily on that E, is what makes the drop sound boring and lifeless. So whenever making drops like this, you need to find the exact correct amount of dissonance for your lead to have. Let's add some dissonance to our drop sound and see how it sounds now. You can achieve a dissonant sound all types of ways: detuning, pitch modulation, frequency modulation, anything that will bring the pitch to a non-steady state. So once again, thanks for watching. I hope some of these concepts will really sink in, because they really are the foundation of the music that you're about to make. Like always, drop a comment if you have any requests, and we'll see you next time. Peace out!